acidification and its effects on Hawaii. I chose this topic because I've already had some background information on this, as I've studied it briefly in the past, and also because I don't think many people know what ocean acidification is and how much it impacts everything and not just the ocean. This is important to learn about because it affects more than the quality of our marine life and our waters. It affects everything overall. And many people in Hawaii eat fish, like poke, and they love to fish, and everyone loves to go to the beach. So, because the quality of our waters are slowly being diminished by the climate changes in our atmosphere, we have to know how to protect it. So learning about it is the first step to preserving it. Three things we're going to cover is, what is ocean acidification, how does it affect marine life, and how does this all affect Hawaii? Okay, so this is a chart to show you the chemistry behind ocean acidification, but basically what happens is the carbon dioxide from our atmosphere, which is a product of fossil fuels and deforestation, it becomes absorbed into the seawater, and that increases the pH level of our water, or it decreases the pH level of our waters, and that's what makes it more acidic. According to the Center for Biological Diversity, about 22 million tons of carbon dioxide from our atmosphere is absorbed into the water every day. This is a pH chart to give you more information, so it's more comparative. And as you can see, the seawater level is at 8.1, which is towards neutral, but the lower it goes on the list, the more acidic. Okay, so how does this affect marine life? That's a photo of coral bleaching from Kaneohe Bay, taken from 2014. Small changes are big changes for marine life. So the acidity disrupts the ecosystem. Coral bleaching is one effect of ocean acidification. As the pH level of ocean water becomes more acidic, coral mortality increases, and calcium carbonate animals, which are animals who produce shells, they have a harder chance at living because the acidity kind of stops them from growing their shells to protect themselves. And same thing for the coral. As the pH level of ocean water becomes more acidic, calcium carbonate animals have a harder time finding suitable habitats to live in. So, yeah. And this is a photo of the marine food chain. So larger fishes depend on the smaller fishes to survive. So if you take away coral, you take away the smaller life forms, and then so forth, cause and effect. So how does all of this affect Hawaii? Ocean acidification affects Hawaii by decreasing our resources and impacting our economy. According to the U.S. Commission on Ocean Policy, coral reefs are responsible for our tourism industry and are worth more than $10 billion. Wow. Moreover, they provide an additional $385 million per year to our economy. The lack of coral reefs means an increase in sea level. This means more coastal erosion. It puts us more at risk during high wavelengths and storms. So we don't have anything to protect ourselves from the waves. These are examples of two species that you can find here. In the top right corner, that's cauliflower coral. And those thrive in the lower, the shallower environments, and those will be the first to be affected by ocean acidification. The one on the bottom left corner is called uku, also known as parrotfish. They scrape the limu off of the coral, so coral depletion means limu depletion means uku depletion. Already endangered animals are twice at risk because of this, so they have to work harder to survive. acidified food and thrive in acidic waters. So far we've covered what ocean acidification is and its causes, how it affects marine life, and how it affects Hawaii. So the big question is, how can we repair our ocean? There are three ways that we can: by increasing renewable transportation to decrease our carbon dioxide emissions in our air. We also have sulfuric acid already, so that's already affecting it, along with the rain, along with the acidity, along with the carbon dioxide. So we have many factors happening here. So if we can get rid of one, that's one way. We can also create coral structures to support areas that are lacking in coral habitat for the ecosystem. And by reducing sunscreen usage with harmful chemicals, because some sunscreens, or probably most sunscreens, carry the chemicals that block the light that reaches the coral, so that kind of affects photosynthesis. So it can't really recuperate much more, plus the acidity, so less recuperation. And that's my presentation, so thank you.
Wow, good job, Chanel. That's